A few months ago, I made a video on the Deco 1 version 2 drawing tablet. This video is a quick follow-up where I will test the Deco 1 version 2 on both a PC and an Android device. So, let's dive in. First, let's connect the Deco 1 to our PC and open the XP-Pen software. This is the software interface. Here, you can adjust the work area. You can manually customize it or choose between the proportional and full area settings. Next, we have the screen settings. Full screen, customize, and identify. In the pen settings, you can customize the pen buttons and adjust the pressure sensitivity. I might need to tweak the hardness here. Make sure to keep the Windows ink selected for smooth performance. An important section is the shortcut keys. The Deco 1 version 2 has 8 buttons, and this is how I have assigned them. Alright, that's all set up. Now, let's open Photoshop and try out a few brush strokes. If you are new to using graphics tablet with Photoshop, you will need to adjust some settings to enable pressure-sensitive brushes. You can find guides online by searching how to use a drawing tablet in Photoshop. I will cover this in more details in a separate video on my channel. Next, let's test Krita. Here's Krita's UI. Let's see how the tablet performs. It seems I had brush smoothing enabled, but now I have turned it off. Let's try a cloud brush. The pen handles angles well and is comfortable to hold. Finally, let's quickly test it on an Android device. I am using an adapter to connect the tablet. I will try it out with Autodesk Sketchbook. It seems to work well, though I might need to use it vertically. The tablet connects effortlessly with Android devices. Overall, I think this tablet is a great choice for beginners. It's easy to connect, has an intuitive user interface, and even comes with a free copy of Artridge Lite. I will add a link in the description about how you can get the Artridge Lite. I highly recommend it for anyone starting out with pen tablets.